Some of it does smell like olive oil. Now, Yes, believe it or not, here's what God told Moses to do in the Old Testament, in the 30th chapter of Exodus. He said, take the finest spices. Then he was specific, 12 pounds of liquid myrrh, 6 pounds of sweet-smelling cinnamon, 6 pounds of sweet cannel, and 12 pounds of cassia. Add 1 gallon of olive oil and make a sacred anointing oil mixture like perfume. Did that smell sweet? Yes, it smelled sweet. It smelled very nice. Guess how many spices they used to make that in olden times? 40. They used 40 spices to make that in olden times. Why? Because how many days did Jesus fast and pray in the wilderness? 40. Nowadays, guess how many they use? They use 57. Now, the patriarch in Constantinople makes it for the Greek Archdiocese, usually about once every 10 years. In other jurisdictions, the Russian Orthodox Church, the Ethiopian, Serbian, etc., the metropolitans make it, and they make it more often. Now, guess how many days it takes to make it? You're close. 3 days. It takes 3 days. And guess what they do? They start on Holy Monday. On Holy Monday, they start and they finish on Holy Wednesday. So what happens is they have that they mix up these spices, 57 of them, plus olive oil in there, and then on Holy Thursday morning, the patriarch or the metropolitan or the head archbishop on Holy Thursday will distribute it. And then it goes out to all of the churches so that we can crispy people. Alright? It's very interesting because a lot of this has its origin in the Old Testament, but we have fulfilled it in the New Testament. Now, the other thing that we did today, we anointed them with the holy oil, the holy chrism, and then we conjured them. Conjured means the cotton scare. And this is always used as an offer. When a baby is born, the baby can't give anything except hopefully it has to give it. So we do it in the form of a cross and Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And also, guess what? Also, we also conjure people. We conjure the deacons and the readers and the priests when they're going to be ordained. So we do that for all of them. Now the last thing I want to mention is the one thing that all of these people did is they came to confession before they were christened. If you're old enough, meaning 7 years and older, and you are going to be baptized or christened, you should come to confession. And what that means is before you enter the church, you want to ask God for forgiveness of sin. We want to come to him with a pure heart. We don't want to hold any grudges or do anything else, any animosity toward anyone. So we want to love one another, as we just heard in the gospel lesson this morning. Okay? So in summary, chrismation, we receive the holy blood. Yes? Holy Spirit. We receive the Holy Spirit, and therefore it's our responsibility to cooperate with the Holy Spirit, because what the Holy Spirit gives us is something from on high. What do we get from the Holy Spirit? Does anybody know this word? Power. Very good. Power from on high. How many of you want that power? The best way to get it is through the Holy Spirit. Okay? So let's make the sign of the cross and then you can get ready.